Start it. Donnie on the track. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team in. Started from the bottom, now we here.
Folks, welcome back. I know it's been a while, but we back. Chapter 3 attempt on the Bossman Show. You know, MLK Day, and I got busy. Coach got busy. John got busy. But guess what? The calendar's turned now. February is getting us crunch time for the season. We're back in the saddle again. Coach, John, and myself. Guys, how are you doing?
I'm doing great, Bossman. We're just plugging away, and I'm interested to get the total of what these game counts are and see who's in the lead heading down the stretch.
Well, Coach, I'm going to give it to you right now. I'm going to recap these games. You know, last week's games, but really it's been a minute before we've been on. So the last set of three that we picked were Kentucky, LSU, Florida, Tennessee, and Mercer, Chattanooga. Okay, so breakdown on those. We all went chalk on the first two games, Coach. You, myself, JR, all picked Kentucky. We were all losers there. We all picked Tennessee. We lost that. And then we all picked, JR and I picked Chattanooga. Coach, you picked Mercer, and Chattanooga came out on top there. So that gives JR and I a one-game edge on you. You're at 8-10. JR and I are 9-9 on the season as we move into our seventh week of action. So we're getting into the three games we've got this week. And JR, I think you got the first preview up today with Cincinnati-Memphis, my man.
Yeah, but I want to get Coach's opinion on being behind you and I. I want to get that from Coach.
I bet you do. I bet you do. Here's my thing. Every team I ever coached, guys, we were playing our best basketball in February and March. So I'd like to think as a coach here going down the stretch, I'm going to be pretty darn good picking these games and finish strong like my team's always did. You know what I mean?
Listen, I can't even beat this cold. I've been fighting for like a month, so you guys should be in pretty good shape.
Well, we'll start off there because, Coach, I'll be at this game on Saturday at the FedEx Forum. Mick Cronin and his Bearcats battling the Memphis Tigers, who are struggling, and there's some things around Josh Pastner where the fans of Memphis want him to be gone. Hopefully Josh can keep his job at Memphis and keep doing well. But in this game, Coach, I want to get you to break this game down. By looks of what I've been seeing, by these guys being playing, I'm going to go with the Bearcats. What is your opinion on this game we have at FedEx Forum on Saturday in Memphis?
Well, I think these are two pretty evenly matched teams. When you look at the statistics, the thing that sticks out more than anything in my mind is the defensive field goal percentage for Cincinnati. They do a great job of defending the basketball. They picked up the pressure the last couple of games and extended their full court press and were more aggressive in the full court than they'd been earlier in the season. I don't know if they'll try to do that on the road against Memphis because that's a tough place to play. Memphis can really score the ball. Chet Goodwin gives them an inside presence. The Lawson twins have been good. The point guard transfer, Ricky Tarrant from Alabama, has been a playmaking guy and gets to the foul line a ton for Tigers. It's going to be a heck of a game. And this is one of those games that I love Coach Pastner. He's a good friend of mine, and I certainly think he deserves to keep his job, no question about it. But this is one of these games he could find a way to win, would really get some equity into his deal for this season and maybe get the fans off his back a little bit. But with all that being said, I think Cincinnati is just too good at the defensive end. They'll find a way to grind this thing out. It's going to be close, probably in the low 60s type of game. But I think Cincinnati goes into the FedEx Forum and finds a way to get that win.
Yeah, Coach, I tend to agree with both you guys. I'm going to roll with Cincy in that ball game. And, you know, the next game we have on the docket is a team that we picked throughout the course of the season here, Michigan State matching up with Michigan in a Big Ten Duke out. Where do you see this game coming out at, Coach? I'm of the opinion that MSU is going to be able to come out on top of this game. I like the style of play, the longevity of that program with Tom Izzo. I think that's a good spot for them. What are your thoughts?
Well, Michigan is a very efficient offensive team. John Beilein is a great offensive coach. Their team doesn't turn it over and beat themselves. They take high percentage shots. They do a great job of spacing the floor and making threes behind the arc. And, you know, Michigan State is a bruising physical type team that kind of just scraps and claws and makes you earn every single thing you get. This is a rivalry game, of course, huge game across that state, not just for Big Ten seeding purposes, but for recruiting purposes. And I think it's going to be a war like it usually is. Denzel Valentine is back and healthy for the Spartans. He changes the complexion of that team when he's healthy. And I think Michigan State understands and knows the only way they can have a chance to win a Big Ten championship is to win out with four conference losses already. So their backs are against the wall. Even though this game is in Ann Arbor at the University of Michigan, I'm going to pick the Spartans to go in there and get the win.
I agree with you, Coach. I'm going to go with the Spartans as well. Last game here, Coach, a battle of two buddies of mine, Andy Kennedy and Kevin Stallings, two guys I respect a lot, good friends of the show. And our Vanderbilt's been struggling a little bit, so it's been Ole Miss, 3-5, 4-4 in SEC play right now. I think this game is a game Vanderbilt needs to win dearly. A key road victory. They don't have that right in the SEC conference right now. So I'm thinking after getting beat by Texas A&M at home on Thursday night, Vandy will be mad and go to Oxford and beat the Rebels down there in their new arena and get a win for Kevin Stallings and the boys. It'll be 5-5 come Saturday in the SEC play.
Well, I'm in agreement with you. I think Vanderbilt is a team right now that is squarely on the bubble. When you look at the projections from a Joe Lenardi and people like that, that right now they're either the last four in, the first four out. They're right there, and they have to have a couple quality wins heading down the stretch. Ole Miss has been up and down a little bit because their point guard, the senior All-American, All-SEC, point guard has had some hamstring problems. So I don't know if he's 100% or not. That'll be really important in this game. With that being said, make it a win. X in college basketball hasn't been quite what people think it should be or thought it would be. And so at some point it's got to click. When you got guys like Wayne Baldwin and you've got Jones inside and the shooters on the perimeter like they have, it's got to click at some point. And I think it starts clicking this week at Ole Miss in a huge game. So I'm like you. I'm going with the Commodores and picking Vanderbilt in this one.
All right, fellas, we got our three games out this week. Cincy-Memphis, Michigan State, Michigan, Vandy, Ole Miss, the only outlier this week for chalk across the board. I'm going Ole Miss, guys. I'm taking you on in the Ole Miss-Vandy game. I think Ole Miss is going to take this game down, so we're going to have a little shifting, a little changing the guard next week as we come on air, fellas.
Well, that's good stuff, man. I think I've got some great games again this week. I look forward to talking with you guys again next week, and get healthy, John, and Boss Man, take care, brother.
You too, Coach. You be good now.
All right. Thank you. Bye-bye.